Hi, my name is Jared Broad, and today we're going to be going over the buy and hold with Forex data in QuantConnect. This bootcamp is going to teach you how to add and request Forex data, how to work with the lot size rounding, and how to place trades with Forex assets. So let's jump into it. Firstly, we're going to learn how to request Forex data. So just like equities data, you use add Forex to request Forex symbols. So with this task, it's asking us to ask for hourly Euro-US dollar data for a specific date range and set the market to be a WANDA. So with Forex data, you can have multiple brokerages or with slightly different data sets. In QuantConnect, we model this as different markets. So the same Euro-US dollar ticker can have slightly different prices depending on the exchanges or the markets that you're trading on. So to make sure that our backtests are accurate, you want to request the right market to be trading in. So let's add Forex data. So we can just use add Forex here and then Euro US dollar. And it's asking for hourly resolution. Just like that. And now we need to set the date range to be the month of May. Okay, awesome. Let's send it off to the cloud and see how we did. QuantConnect has all of the data from FXCM and Awanda, which is about 85 tickers, all the way back to 2005, 2004, depending on which brokerage you're trading on. Oh, look at that. So we've added Forex, but we forgot to ask for the right market. So we can fix that by adding market here. So in this case, we've added market Awanda, but we also have market FXCM. But for the test, let's just ask for market Awanda. Okay, awesome, we passed the task. Let's move on to the next one. So now we're going to set the brokerage model for this algorithm. Brokerage models allow you to set a lot of common settings that are for one brokerage. So for example, when you set the Awanda or the FXCM brokerage model, it automatically sets the fee model for that brokerage and the slippage and the leverage that you're allowed to use. So there's a lot of brokerage specific settings that rather than forcing you to go and set them one by one, you can just ask for the right brokerage model and it'll automatically set them for you. So here it's saying ask, make the algorithm request the Awanda brokerage model. So this is a setting on the algorithm. You do self.set brokerage model. And then you pass in the brokerage name enum. You can see a full list of the brokerages available here and the different models that we've implemented for you. But that should be enough to set this. Okay, awesome. We're past the task and on to the next one. Okay, now we're going to access Forex price data. Unlike equities, Forex data is mostly bids and asks. In rare circumstances, you can get Forex trade data, but the data that we have is Forex bid and ask data. So each of these is available in the bid and ask property of that slice. So this task is asking us to save the ask price of hourly data at a specific time. So how are we going to get the time? How are we going to get the price? So we can use the self.time property of the algorithm to get the algorithm's time. The algorithm self.time is the backtest time. And in this case, it's going to be flowing from May 1st to May 31st. And so if you make a statement here, you could say if self.time dot hour. So you're going to be accessing the Python DateTime object that's stored inside this time property. So if the hour is 10 and We want the first day of the month only. Then we want to save the euro-US dollar ask price. So this is accessible inside the data object here. And then you need to pass in the ticker that we're trading. And we want the asking price. Okay, so we have this ask object here, but what's inside of it? Just like trade data, quote bar data has a full range of open, high, low, close values of the ask price or the bid price. So this is actually a bar with its own properties. So we can go ask.close to get the close of that asking bar. So next one, which doesn't actually have an objective, but it seems like it's extra points. Let's print out the value of that price. Okay, now we'll just fetch that last error there. And let's submit our answer for processing. You can see here we're debugging the price, so we can actually have a look at the price. We can see that in the console. There you go, you've got the $1.09 came through, and we passed the task. Let's move on to the next one. Depending on your brokerage, some brokerages restrict the orders to be round lots. This means that your orders need to be rounded to a specific number. For most Forex data, this is rounded to the nearest $1,000, as Forex trades can be rather large sometimes. So to make their life simpler, the brokerages say that you need to round it to the nearest 1,000, and you can do this with the lot size. So here we can see that we can access the lot size for your brokerage using this value. I can get a little hint from the documentation over here. And you can see here the securities collection, which is the collection of the data that we've added to the algorithm. And we can use euro-US dollar. So now we have saved the lot size for that asset to this variable. Next, it's asking us to use the debug statement to print out this lot size information. So we just need to pass that in. If you notice here, self.lotsize is a number, and so we have to use the string method to convert that to a string for the debug statement. Finally, it's asking us to round the order quantity and print the order size value. So it's given us a little hint here. We can use the round function here to take this order quantity, divide it by our lot size, and multiply it by the lot size to then round it to the nearest lot size value. So let's print out that value. So again here we're using the string helper to print out the rounded order size for the debug statement. Okay, let's see how we went. Okay. You can see here in the debug statement that the lot size for this brokerage is 1, and so the rounded order size has been rounded to the nearest 1, as we expected. Okay, awesome, we passed the task. Let's see what's next. Okay, it looks like we're going to be placing some Forex orders. This will probably pull together everything we've learned so far, rounding the orders to the nearest lot size, and asking for data. So we can see here that we can use the market order and limit order methods just like equities. And also just like equities, we can use the set holdings helper to get a fraction of our total portfolio value. So it's asking us to request OANDA hourly resolution data and then ask for the OANDA brokerage model. Let's see how we go. Now, if you remember, you need to use the set brokerage model helper. And then we need to use the brokerage name enum to set the brokerage model. Okay, next, in the OnData, use a market order to order 2000 units of AUD USD. We need to use portfolio.invested to make sure we only submit one order. Okay. So we can say if we're not invested, then we place our market order. And we want to order 2,000 units. Okay, let's see how we went. All right, awesome. We just passed the buy and hold Forex tutorial. And in that time, you've learned how to request Forex data, set a brokerage model, round all the lot sizes, and then finally place a trade for Forex to your brokerage. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.